Hello, everybody, and welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here with my esteemed colleagues, Shaquille O'Neal and Jeff Smith. And tonight, it'll be the Houston Rockets going up against the Cavaliers in Cleveland. And for Cleveland, they're looking to come out strong and make their mark early. They have to look at this game as a great opportunity to do just that. One of the guys to watch tonight is going to be Kevin Love. He's got that great combination of skill and motor, one of the more versatile power forwards in the game, Kenny, with that specific skill set.
Yeah, his skill set is really unique because he is a power forward who also can be a finesse forward. He can throw those long-range outlet passes and then step back for a three. So it really is difficult to guard this guy, and his offensive approach is great.
You know, he's basically known for rebounding. His numbers were down last season, but he's still one of the best rebounders.
This city is glowing on this wonderful clear night. A terrific view of Cleveland right there. Welcome to 2K Sports for another edition of NBA Basketball. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Craig Anthony and Clark Kellogg. Home court advantage goes to the Cavaliers playing here in Quicken Loans Arena. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. And so in the game for the Rockets. Mota Yunus and Howard, the post pair. Lillian Harden, they're the backcourt. And it's Ariza in at the small forward position. Playing alongside James Harden, a lot less pressure too on Dwight Howard to carry the load offensively these days. It's certainly, Clark, made things easier for him.
Not only easier, I think it's been more comfortable for him as a secondary scorer. Rolling to the rim, crashing the offensive glass, those are things he can do at a high level for a lot longer, I think.
And so the Houston Rockets get the first points of the ball game. Back to Harden. Lots of room. And the shot no good, a bit short.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Observing. James outside. Back to Irving. Six to shoot. Irving double teamed. James wide open. Good, and the assist goes to Irving.
And listen, Howard took his share of criticism for not being more aggressive and polished.
Whoa! He has a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
Yeah, wow. That could very well be a contender for Dunk of the Year and perhaps might make its way all over the internet.
I tell you what, that is the crowd pleaser of all crowd pleasers.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. Look at that shot! Back to Harden. Houston moving the ball around. We've got 1:55 left in the first. Here's Howard. Good D by Love.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Great assist that time by Kyrie Irving.
There's a minute 40 left here in the first quarter. And Beverly kicks to Harden. Pass to Howard. They double team Howard. And he was camped in the lane there. And he gets the 3 second call. And the Cavaliers will go with a different look here. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Shumpert is checked in for J.R. Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Kyrie Irving. And a switch here also for Houston. Michaels, he's checked in for Monta Yunus. Here's LeBron, down to five on the shot clock. Off target on the outside leaner.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that one.
Howard gets to Ariza. Takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup. Cavaliers leading. Mozgov dishes to LeBron. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. two summers ago, all anyone could talk about was LeBron James and the return to Cleveland.
I mean, you couldn't write that stuff, Kevin. I mean, it was unbelievable, the storyline. I mean, after all the acrimony between LeBron and the ownership as well as the fans. But you know what? He said it best. He truly is back where he belongs.
He's home.
Yes.
He's home. Here's Beasley. Passes it to Terry. Here's Brewer. Sinks the triple. Brewer's got himself a three there.
Poor job defensively, giving him such a clear look at the basket from three-point range.
And, you know, for LeBron, he knew he had his work cut out for him in Cleveland. A younger team, unseasoned in the playoffs, they had to remake the roster a bit and gain that experience.
Capella with the bucket.
Oh, that is just weak defense there. I'm pretty sure that was not the plan to give him those kind of baskets at the hoop.
LeBron passes to Fry. Off target from three-point range. Here's McDaniels. Pass to Brewer. Beyond the arc. No luck. He caught up with Kyrie Irving earlier, and he talked a little bit about expectations for himself.
We expect so much.
Kyrie reminding us that it's not just the expectations of the fans and the media he and LeBron deal with, but also, in part, perhaps the most demanding of all are the expectations they've got for each other.
Yeah, that's a great point. I mean, two guys who expect so much of themselves to start with, who naturally have a vision of how great the other guy should be. I mean, they're constantly trying to manage expectations while still demanding the best from each other. And that's a lot of fun to watch.
Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second quarter going back here. And looking at what we've seen from Houston, what do you guys think?
You know, it's been about how solid they've been offensively here, really tuned in with one another.
Good ball movement, and it's paid off on the scoreboard.
So on the floor for Houston, they've got Terry Beasley out there with Corey Brewer, and it's McDaniels in at the two. The Rockets were terrific on the road last season, Clark. Tied for second with the Clippers for the most road wins in the league.
26-15, although if you want to get picky about it, they had one of those wins in Mexico City, so maybe 25.5 road wins for them.
And we play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. Capella kicks to Terry. Launches a three. Thompson with the rebound. Cleveland's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Smith dishes to Thompson. Rockets with the rebound. Beasley left side. Soft touch off the glass. Beasley's got his first points of the game.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
That's right. Five of their last six makes were on the interior. They've established their inside presence.
For Houston, they've gone 2 of 5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. It's Terry outside. It's rebounded by Cleveland. Thompson's got 4 rebounds in this game. Irving with it, guarded now by Jason Terry. Got a piece of it. Brewer with the steal. Here's McDaniels. Poked loose. Cavaliers shooting at 50% in a decent groove. Smith. Here's Dellavedova. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Really on the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
Yeah, exactly. Prevent the layup. Give him a little bump, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming into the lane next time. And if they don't think about it, at least they might be distracted by your presence.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. James checked in for J.R. Smith. And it's Amon Shumpert in for Kyrie Irving.
Both teams trading punches back and forth. This thing's like a heavyweight fight.
The momentum swings, really impossible to keep track of. The energy in the building just keeps going back and forth, ebbing and flowing.
Oh!
How's that for a one-man show? Put this fellow on Broadway. Self-service.
The most magnificent alley-oop he could have chosen.
Yeah, and he pulls that one off, guys, to perfection.
Oh, man. Takes the alley-oop pass and dunks it down. And out of bounds is the right. Rockets gain possession.
I tell you what, that's just a major unforced error right there, guys. My goodness.
44 seconds left in the first half of the game. Harden kicks to Beverly. Back to Harden. And some nice passing there by Houston. And it's Ariza in the corner. Takes a three. Cavaliers with the rebound. James in the post. Working on Howard. And Fry kicks to LeBron. Anunis with the steal. And here comes Harden. Leading the fast break. And he gets the bucket. Harden's got his second basket of the night.
Boy, I tell you what. Nice little run here they're going on.
And getting to the 10 has been the key. They're getting point-blank looks time and time again.
Boy, you gotta love that assist by LeBron.
It's stolen by Iman Shumpert. Got it off in time. Got it off in time, but it's no good. And
thank you.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you. Houston found themselves in a close game in the first. They were able to squeeze ahead by the end of the period. All right, that is going to wrap up our halftime report as it's just...
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Without question, Trevor Ariza displaying his skills today.
I know we've said this many times before, but what a great first half. Just an offensive juggernaut.
And, you know, in the end, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had, guys. I mean, he can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
Kyrie Irving and J.R. Smith at the guard set. LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. And it's Thompson in at the five. So that's who's on the floor for the Cavaliers. Ariza outside. Down to five on the shot clock. It's Harden.
Sublime stuff, guys. Absolutely sublime.
Clark, he's going to start putting on a show now.
And that's usually how it goes. Once they get that lead, it's almost like they give him free reign.
That slam cam replay really gave you a good look at the action. And for Trevor Ariza, almost exclusively a perimeter player on the offense last year. New scheme, Greg, new teammates, big adjustments.
Yeah, the Rockets having Dwight Howard camping out in the lane and James Harden needing space for dribble drives. Not much room to operate inside for Ariza.
But they do like his defense, and we know he can hit the three. It's a pretty valuable commodity for him. Harden inside the three-point line, and Houston again with the bucket.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today. Yeah, real nice shot selection there. I guess he's working on his buzzer beater form.
That's a reach, but perhaps that is the case. Or maybe he was trying to knock a bird off of the scoreboard.
He's about right, because I still can't figure that one out.
No, I see no birds up there.
No.
And they double him up with LeBron. Irving with a clean look. Yes. And it's picking up the assist. Irving's got his first 2 points of the night.
You know, you talk about Trevor Ariza last season. I mean, his field goal percentage dipped to 40, mostly because he only took threes, or so it appeared. It's hard to be efficient if you're only shooting threes.
Harden. Another miss by Harden. The Cavaliers trail by six. It's offline from half court. Beverly wide open. The Rockets again can't hit.
You guys, when you think about Trevor Ariza, he was signed by Houston last year to play defense. And did he deliver on that end? He was usually matched up against the opponent's best wing scorer, and he had the highest steals average of his career, almost two a game. Add to that, he is a knockdown shooter from beyond the arc.
A three. No luck. So Cleveland will take it the other way. 11 left in the third quarter. Irving passes to Thompson. In the corner, Smith with it. James outside. Out to the right wing. Love with a wide open look. And a miss there on the triple.
You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, as a coach, you can really ill afford to have those types of opportunities presented against your defense.
Think back to the 2009 draft, the Thunder selecting James Harden third overall, and there was some second guessing there.
Yeah, and Tyreke Evans, Kevin, taking a pick after him, won Rookie of the Year, but with time, Harden's talent has proven, and you could argue he should have gone first in that draft.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tristan Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Shumpert is checked in for J.R. Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Irving. From deep, Harden. It's hauled in by Fry.
And you know, you think of Harden on the Thunder, they didn't want to give him that max contract, but it's hard to argue that he's not worth every penny. And this should be the last possession of the quarter.
Exactly. I'm right with you there, Greg. I mean, no need to give the ball back before the end of the quarter. Make sure you get the last shot here.
Here's Harden on the wing. Jacks up a three. Off on that one. And we're set to start the action up here in the fourth quarter. And if it's anything like the first three, we should be in for a treat. The Cavaliers trail by four. Fourth quarter on the court for the Rockets. They've got Brewer, Trevor Ariza out there with Beasley. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Capella in at the five, down low. And for Houston, they're shooting reasonably well, 45%. Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop. Not to be. Good play defensively. Here's Irving. And all around the rim that time before dropping in. Irving's got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Cavs. Brewer with the ball. Here's Capella. It's blocked. Shumpert against Ariza. Shumpert, no good.
Very dangerous to leave a guy like that open. Lucky break there for the D.
And Brewer kicks to Beasley. Now the pass to Brewer. Back to Beasley. Fades back. Can't get it to go. Good work defensively by Smith. To the paint. To tie it up. Kicks it to Fry. Back to Smith. And Michael Beasley picks up the foul. And Cleveland making a change here. Thompson's checked in. And a switch here also for Houston. KJ McDaniels, he's checked in for Brewer. Moving against Beverly. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
Got a good look, though. I thought that was going to go down.
Yeah, the D, though, just enough to bother the rhythm on that one, Clark.
Cleveland's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Beasley with the steal. And it's Houston on the break. Ahead. Houston moving it around. Wide open look. And that one's good. Beverly. And the Rockets lead by four. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for the Rockets?
Boy, they're hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end. Very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
Yeah, and also the way they've been able to generate points off of the turnovers that they forced tonight has also helped.
He kicks to McDaniels. Nice shot from the wing. There's a minute 47 left to play in the final quarter. Smith dishes to Irving, and there's the call on Patrick Beverley. That's his first foul.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
Braun, he's checked for Shumpert. Mantiunas is checked in Houston. Harden comes in for K.J. McDaniels. Rockets leading by three. The three from Harden. Not that time, his six miss. He's made 4 of 10 so far. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Irving.
Oh, that certainly could be costly. And a close one. Those kinds of mistakes can really give the other team momentum.
Dwight Howard's in for Michael Beasley. In the corner, Mantiunas with it. Harden outside. He dishes it to Beverley. .106 left here in the fourth quarter. Shot clock at 6. Ariza with the bucket.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
Great ball movement.
The Cavaliers trail by 5. From deep, James. Outside, Irving. Love outside. Thompson passes to Irving. They had a number of cracks at it, but came away empty. And now decide to foul intentionally. And an intentional foul right there. It's the third that increases their lead to 6. And so he drops them both. It's a 7-point game.
The free throws go down and the lead goes up.
So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Guys, untidy. You've got to value the possession of the basketball.
Simply put, out of control is how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline.
Back to Harden. Gets to Ariza. The Rockets with another miss. And even 3-on-3 break. Offensive rebound, kicks it out to James. Money!
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
So we see the Rockets get the win here. They seem to relish their role as the